Gold viewers from around the world. I'm Kristen Schwartz, licensed midwife and MC for Gold Learning. And today I'm sitting down with Dr. Mary Regan, and she will be presenting birth, eating, and the microbiota. So I wanted to chat a little bit with her and introduce her to our listeners. So welcome, Mary.
Hello, thanks for having me.
Mary, you're presenting on birth, eating, and the microbiota. So before we delve into the topic itself, can you tell us a little bit about yourself and your professional journey?
Well, my professional journey started in England, where I did nursing and midwifery, and then I moved to Canada. And primarily, I'd done midwifery really to work in neonatal ICU. But the further in I got, the more I realized that it was birth itself and the conduct of birth that I really loved and where my passion lay. And so that's largely where I've spent my years in clinical practice, which I think in total were about 18 years, 19 years. So my husband, we lived in Canada, and I was working as an advanced practice clinician in a large tertiary unit. And I had just started graduate school and my husband was transferred to the States. So I moved with him, but came down as an F2 visa, which meant that I couldn't work. And so I was offered a pre-doc at the University of Minnesota, which I took up, and I did my PhD there, focused again in my dissertation on how women make decisions about birth, with a view I made my dissertation was focused on how nurses make decisions about care that could influence the utilization of cesarean section. So when I got my PhD, I was offered a position at University of Maryland. I just completed at that time my postdoc from the National Library of Medicine in bioinformatics, and once again focused on behavioral bioinformatics, where we look at how these technologies influence practices and behaviors. So I took up a position at Maryland, and that's where I've been ever since. And I now conduct research on the microbiome and childbirth outcomes, and extended a fair bit to include women's health and STIs and various other aspects. So for me, the microbiome provided a means to explain things that I'd seen in practice and didn't have a response to why that would happen. And so it's become a great passion of mine. It is a very new area of research. And so a lot of the research that we do is knowledge generating, which is exciting, but sometimes can affect your funding rates. But I certainly haven't had that problem. I'm funded by the National Institute of Research and very well supported by them. And I work with Jacques Revelle, also at the University of Maryland, who is famous for his work on the vaginal microbiome. So that's how I came to be where I am now.
Yes, you have such a rich background, not only in practical background with birth itself, but also a deep background in research and at the universities as well. So, and you just told us a little bit how you got interested in the topic of the microbiome. So tell us a little bit more. Is there anything that surprised you when you started looking into the microbiome? Anything you learned that you felt, wow, this is certainly a surprise. This is definitely something new.
Yeah, so there's a number of things. I think in the R01 that I currently have, which is for those of you who don't know the mechanisms here, an R01 is a 5-year research science award, and we're in our 5th year now. So this is the study we've recruited over 200. I think we're 246 women now, and we follow them longitudinally. So we follow them for almost 6 months. And I think what surprised me is I'll tell you a bit more about this in the presentation, but we recruit from a very high-risk population, but we have an extremely low rate of preterm birth. And so the surprise for me has been that we can modify physiology just by engagement. And so it's something that's very interesting. It's something that we will be doing more research on, and I certainly will talk more about it in the presentation.
Yeah, I can't wait to listen to your presentation. This is sounds like very exciting, especially with what you just mentioned about the high-risk population that you are researching on. And I know this is difficult because you could probably talk about this topic for hours, but we are on a limited time here. What would you like our delegates to take away from the presentation?
Well, I think what the research, my research and research on the microbiome across the board is showing is that the microbes have a fundamental influence on physiologic function. And so we need to use care practices that promote physiology, not override them. So go the natural route. It definitely works. That's how our bodies are engineered. And when you start messing around by, for example, giving oxytocin, or when there's not r a really strong clinical need, you can change physiology to the point that it has an influence, an adverse influence on outcomes.
Yeah, that sounds good. I like just right now what you said. That really spoke to me. Go the natural route. Our bodies are designed that way. That is a really, really a good statement. And Mary, I'm so glad that you took the time to chat with me today about your upcoming presentation, Birth Eating and the Microbiome. And Mary's presentation is part of the Microbiome in the Perinatal Period lecture pack. Please check it out. It is a fantastic lecture pack on the latest research on the microbiome in the perinatal period. And for more information on this presentation and on other presentations in this lecture pack, please visit www.goldperinatal.com. Thank you again, Mary, for sharing your time and expertise with me here today. And thank you, everybody, for listening. Bye-bye.
Thanks.